Every family has a story to tell. Welcome to Suzanne Valleys, full of love.
My name is Suzanne Valley. I live in the foothills of the Appalachian Mountains in Adams County, southeastern Ohio. I am currently raising four of my nieces and nephews. They're my brother, my youngest brother's children. Due to drug addiction, because of the children, I decided to get into foster care, so I'm also a foster parent here.
In Adams County, if drugs are the reason innocent victims, kids, are taken from their parents, then those drugs are usually opiates.
There's so many people that are addicted, that are losing their children. That's what I call the lost generation, are the children that are being left behind. Delaney is 12, Finian is 11, Liam's 9, and Connelly 7.
It started with Suzanne's brother's kids, who she's raised on and off for years. She hopes he can break from heroin's hold. Until then,
I can't protect them from the world, but I can give them a stable home, decent education, encourage them to go on to college, help them make their dreams, and just give them the things that I know they wouldn't have.
3, 4, 5.
Oh, darn!
Happiness, stability, hope. There's a lot of that here. This 5-month-old foster baby has been with Suzanne since he was 3 days old.
If he came up for adoption, I'd probably do it. I couldn't help it. I mean, you fall in love with them. They're innocent babies. They're innocent children. And I'm hoping that his parents are gonna be able to do the right thing. They're gonna stay clean and they're gonna be reunited with them. I mean, that's my dream for all the kids.
But until then, she'll be here for them. Yay! One weekend, she took in 5 extra siblings. It was an emergency. Most of the time, they have a hard time adjusting to her normal, loving home. It's not their normal.
The foster children that have come through my home, I've noticed that as much as I try to give them food, attention, love, they don't understand it because they don't have it.
That's why retirement can wait.
We had our dreams of retiring to Mexico.
Suzanne knows these little people can't.
This is the calling. I know this is a calling on my life, and that's why I do it, okay? And it's hard. I'm not gonna say it's easy. There's times I wanna rip my hair out. But then when I look at them, I know that I'm making a difference for them. I don't really like being in the limelight for things, but I want people to know that there is hope for the people out there. There's hope for the drug addicted. There's hope for the children. We just have to just band together and do one small thing, no matter what it is, just do one thing. Just do your part. And maybe as a whole, we can, maybe in 10 years from now, we can look back and go, we did it, you know, and people are getting better. And there's more to life than that. So much more out there, right? That's what I think too.